Just the other day, I think it was about 4 days ago, I was in an LRT train in Bukit Panjang. I met a young undergraduate from NTU. His name was Thaddeus Wheat. He was very surprised to see me on an LRT. I guess he doesn't expect ministers to ride the LRT. So his first question to me was, why should I vote for you? And before I could even answer, he said, I know what you've already done. Bukit Panjang is fantastic. You've changed it so much in the last 10 years, last 5 years. We got almost everything that we want. Yes, there's still a few more things to be done, but almost everything that needs to be done has been done. So don't tell me about what you've done. What's your plans for the future? So I explained, I said, we believe we want a happy, safe, and harmonious town. We want a town that is, you know, Bukit Panjang, they used to say it was ulu. We want to say, no, this is not an ulu town. This is as upmarket as you have here in Clementi Avenue 4. This is a town that is modern, but also will be green. This is a town that will have facilities. So the sports complex is an example. We will build more park connectors. We will make this place special. So he nodded. He said, okay, that's interesting. I might support you for that. But he says, I've got some more questions. Many of the people who don't like you say you wasted money. So I said, oh, I wasted money? He said, YOG, Youth Olympic Games. Tell me about it. Explain to me how it came about. This is the young man asking me. So I thought, I better respect this man. He's got a good question, and I must answer it openly and honestly. So I told Thaddeus, quite frankly, we got the initial estimates of the money that needed to be spent on the Youth Olympic Games wrong. We got it wrong because this was the world's first ever Youth Olympic Games. Never been done before. First time ever. We had no other models or precedents to follow. The IOC decided in August to have it. In November, 3 months later, they asked us to put in a bid. So our initial estimates were wrong. And in fact, even after the IOC chose us, I told Thaddeus, it took more than a year before they could confirm the detailed requirements to conduct these games. So after a year, almost a year and a half later, and all the detailed specifications, and we realize this may be the Youth Olympic Games, but it's one-third the size of the Summer Olympics, and it's got all 26 sports, and all the athletes are going to stay for the entire 2 weeks. We quickly did our sums, but carefully, and we realized it will cost a lot more. So what did I do? I went to see the Prime Minister. I said, Mr. Lee, this is the latest set of figures. So he looked at it carefully, and he looked at me, and he said, if you had known in November 2007 that the Youth Olympic Games will cost more than $300 million, would you still have bid for it? And I answered him very honestly, this is the first and possibly last time ever the Olympic event will be held in Singapore. And it will make a big difference for our young people in Singapore. And I told him, I would have bid for it even if I knew that price tag. So he then turned around and told me, okay, in that case, you make sure you do not overspend the budget. So we decided 387 will be the maximum, but in the end, we spend much less. Then we conducted the games, and it was a success. Everyone external to Singapore, and many people, most people within Singapore agree that it was a success. But of course, there are others who are entitled to their own opinions about whether or not it was a success. But I want to make this point, that we did not overspend or waste or squander money which was properly budgeted for these games. I got a separate approval for this money so that I would not have to cut back on expenditure on the other important items in MCYS. The other important items are expenditures on families, expenditures on social safety net. So it was a completely separate budget. But now that it is over, whatever criticisms come my way, let me just tell you from my heart that I am proud of the Youth Olympic Games. I am proud of the way our Singaporean athletes competed and did so well, won 2 silver and 5 bronze medals against world-class competition. And they deserve our congratulations. I am so proud of the 50,000 volunteers and performers, ordinary Singaporeans, some of whom, in fact, I met one this morning while walking around, who volunteered their time, made great sacrifices because they wanted to be part of a once-in-a-lifetime event and to put Singapore on the world map, and because they were quietly proud of Singapore. This was the Singapore spirit. 50,000 volunteers and performers. And I'm proud of them, and so should you. We had several hundred thousand spectators coming to watch the games. People said, oh no, no one will be interested. But in the end, my greatest problem was too many people wanted to attend. I had to change the rules for the sale of tickets so that as many people who could attend could fill up the place. The spectators came. And we had not only spectators in Singapore. According to IOC, we had 266 million spectators outside Singapore, suddenly watching world-class events in Singapore. But that's not all. Yes, we spent a significant sum of money, but 70% of all that money was spent on local companies providing services, and providing services at an international standard which will allow these companies in future to compete and to provide services at other international events. So another reason for pride, pride in the achievements of our Singaporean companies. So my friends, after that, I explained all this to Thaddeus. He nodded his head. He said, okay, you made the right decision. The most important aspect of that, which you should have explained to people, is that it was about Singaporean athletes and Singaporean volunteers. It was a celebration of the Singaporean spirit. So you see, this young man taught me something. He taught me that it is not just about money, but it is about people and the spirit. Then we had other bits of discussion, but at the end of the day, I think we spent half an hour, then he shook my hand, he said, okay, you have my vote. Because you have plans for the future, you care, you are responsible, and you answer my questions honestly, and you take criticisms honestly. That, to me, is a very precious one vote from that young man. The second element that young people have taught me is that success is not good enough. You know? They want a fair and just society. What does fairness mean? I think we don't need to be too, you know, detailed in it, but all Singaporeans know, have a deep sense of fairness, right? It's not that we get equal reward, but it must be something which our conscience can accept. So let me give you some examples of fairness. 2 nights ago, after my first rally, I met Mr. Jack Lai. You know, our first rally was held in Bukit Panjang in a field as muddy as this, and he was there in a wheelchair. I wondered how he could move his wheelchair on mud, but somehow he came. At the end of the rally, I met him. He hugged me, and there were tears in his eyes, and I in almost in mine too. And he said, "I can see your sincerity, and I know you will do your best to look after me. That yes, I may be a paraplegic, stuck in a wheelchair, but I asked you for a job. You're helping arrange a job for me. I am a Paralympian. He wants to go to the London Olympics to compete, and he knows I will support him. And he understands that I respect him as a Singaporean." That's an example of fairness.